And here we are, another nice sunny morning, and Bob was working a bit later, had the model split up into different work sets, and now Doug is going to open up his local file or create a new local file as we learned. And now he's going to go in, and the first thing he's going to do is notice that his file, I'm just looking here, is not. If I pick on here, let me see, that is not picking up the new stuff. So now, interesting, Doug has opened up his file in the morning, and his local file is a little bit out of sync. So what's he going to do? He's going to go up to here. First thing he's going to do in the morning is synchronize with Central. Okay, and all of a sudden, I would have thought that when he opened that file, it would synchronize automatically, and it's not. So there's an interesting point. When you open your local file, the first thing you should do is synchronize. Okay, now we can see there's that extra piece of furniture, and if I pick on these items, we'll see that it's on the work set. So there's a something that got away from me is that we should synchronize as soon as we open our local file to make sure that it is reading the most recent central file. So you can see everything here has been split up. Okay, now Doug and Bob are both at work. So let's go over here. And here's Bob, and Bob opens up his file. So Bob's going to open up his, Doug's going to open up his. And today, Bob is going to work on exterior walls, and Doug is going to work on interior. So what happens is now we go into here and Bob is actually going to go exterior walls and he's going to say yes. He's going to check it out. Hit OK. And now all the walls that are exterior walls are his. He doesn't have to check them out. He's checked out the entire set. So he can go in and make changes and move this stuff around. Exterior walls, no problem. If he tries to move something that's not one of the exterior walls, he's going to notice. You see, there's no icon here. If he picks on this guy, he can see that he hasn't. Doesn't have that checked out. Now, this is where it's you can get a cross between checking out the entire work set and borrowing an item. Let's say he just wants to move this wall. Well, if no one has, you see, this is in work set interior partitions. At this point, no one has interior partitions checked out. So if Bob decides to go in and nudge this wall, he can nudge it, nudge it. Now he's moved it, okay? And he's edited it, but he's also borrowed it. Now, and he was able to borrow it because no one has that work set checked out. If I go into here, we can see that Bob owns exterior walls. Bob has borrowed an item from interior partitions. Okay, so now watch. He's going to say, that's all I wanted to do. So he says, good, go up here, synchronize with settings, and I'm going to relinquish my borrowed items, but I'm not going to relinquish these user-created work sets that I've done. So he's going to synchronize with the main model. Okay, any changes he made to the exterior walls will now be on the central file as well as this, but this guy has now been relinquished back to the central file for anyone to edit or borrow. Okay, now let's try something else. Here we go, we're now over with Doug, and Doug tries to edit an exterior wall. So he goes over here, and he notices that, of course, he doesn't have it checked out. If Doug goes over to here and picks on here, he can see that Bob has exterior walls checked out. Okay, so what happens if he goes in here and he tries to nudge this? When he nudges it, he's going to say, you can't edit this until Bob resaves the element to the central file and relinquishes it. So he say, okay, no problem. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to try it again, nudge, and it's going to let me place a request. Close that off, place a request, and then I can just cancel that. Okay, now we go over to here. All of a sudden, Bob's in here. Guess what? Bob gets a message. Doug wants to borrow one of your items. So now what I want to do is I want to, first of all, I want to synchronize, okay? And I don't want to give up my exterior, right? I'm going to continue to keep the set checked out, but I am going to let him borrow it. So watch. First thing I need to do is synchronize. That's the first thing you have to do no matter what. Then what I'm going to do is go into my editing request, and I'm going to go up to Doug and say, yes, grant him permission. close it off. So I've granted him permission to edit this one wall. So right now I can't edit this. Okay? And now granted by Bob, and that's just come up because I'm using the same computer. But now even though I have exterior walls checked out as a work set, this one element has been borrowed or lent over to Doug. So I go back over to here. Here's Doug. Doug can't edit this one, but now he's been granted permission to do this one. Now if Doug goes into his editing request, nothing's pending, okay, because he's been granted everything. So now he can take this and go nudge, 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 nudge. That's all I wanted to do. Oh, he's got a little problem. And then he can say, good, let's save and relinquish. Synchronize, relinquish my borrowed items, done. Go back out, okay. Doug's done. Now we go back over to Bob. And there's Bob. And Bob, now if he picks on here, he notices that he cannot edit it, and that's because he needs to synchronize. So once he does his synchronize, he doesn't have to give anything up. He'll realize that this wall A, watch it move, okay? There it goes. And B, now he can edit it because it's back in the normal editing mode. So really from here on in, it's a process of setting your active work set for new items. Remember, just because it's a door doesn't mean it knows it goes in the door work set. Okay, it'll go on whatever is the active work set. If you copy it, it probably, let's take this guy and copy it from here to here. Okay, escape, escape. Did it go in exterior walls or did it go in doors and windows? Oh, that's in work set one. What about this one? That's in work set one. Well, then that would definitely be in, oh, it's in exterior walls. So look, when you copy it, it goes into the active work set. Okay? Copy an item. This is in work set one. I thought we had done that splitting up of doors and windows. Maybe we didn't. Or we didn't do it on each floor. So I could do that. But when you're moving items from work set to work set, that's really a maintenance thing. Editing them is one thing, but actually taking objects and going like this and changing their work set, you have to be a bit careful with that because everyone's kind of in the model and editing. Okay, so as I was alluding to say, it's a process now basically going in here and checking out which work sets you want. If you go in here and I am in as Bob and I say, okay, I'm going to give that back, it's going to say, well, you will remain the borrower of the elements that you change. So really what I want to do is I want to go in here. Now what's happened is I've given up the work set. Someone else can check it out. But the few items that I've changed, now I've borrowed. So they've gone from editing the entire work set. I've given up the work set for someone else to check out. But the few items I edited, I've borrowed. So those I can get rid of by going synchronize and give up the borrowed elements. So now I'm back to not having anything borrowed or anything checked out. So Bob is free and clear of anything. Okay. We go over here to Doug. What's Doug got going on? His active work set is work set one. He can change his active work set to be something else. Pick on here. What's he got going? He doesn't have anything checked out. Maybe he's going to work on, railings. So let's go to railings. Yes, he's got railings checked out. Okay, let's go to our second floor. Where is there a railing? Is that a railing? Click on the railing. Guess what? I can just go in and edit that railing now because I've checked out the work set. Drag it over, finish it. Boom. No borrowing, no nothing. Okay? Back in here, that's because I've got it actually checked out. Now watch. If I go in here and say no, I give up the work set to be checked out by someone else, but that one little railing guy is still borrowed by me. Okay, this railing over here has been given up with the work set, but this guy here I kept as a borrowed item. Very smart. Okay, so relinquish mine doesn't synchronize. Relinquish just relinquishes it. Oh, it says you have to save before you relinquish. Okay, so we want to go save, which saves my local file. Relinquish. Oh, I need to save to central. Okay, so I might as well just do this. Borrow and synchronize. Relinquish my borrowed items and synchronize. Now back to my work sets, I don't have anything checked out. So a little bit about the multiple work sets and checking them out and borrowing items from one user to the next.